Hello, my name is Kay, and during this video I'm going to show you how to control our PicoScope devices with the example LabVIEW programs we provide in our software development kit or SDK. Well, I've already downloaded the SDK from the website, so if you open it up, inside you find a LabVIEW folder with all our LabVIEW examples. But before we open them, we want to make sure the drivers are in the correct place. These are the 32-bit drivers. As I'm using a 32-bit LabVIEW, I will be using them. But if I was using 64-bit, I would have to be using these two here. If I copy them across to the LabVIEW resource folder, I go into C, program files x86, because I'm using a 64-bit operating system, national instruments, LabVIEW 2013, resource. And then we paste the drivers into this folder. Right. Now that's done, I can go back to my SDK and go into LabVIEW and open up the example block. As you can see, an error has come up. If you open that up, you can see that it looked in the resource folder for the PS4 files and ADLL and has found it where we just placed it, as that is where LabVIEW will look for it first. Now, this is what the front panel looks like. If you press this button here, it will then run. The splash screen shows that you are now connected to the driver. And we are getting a value in channel A. Channel B sees nothing as it is not enabled. Now, if you want to stop the application, you have to press stop. If you use the abort execution, you are going to have to forcibly close LabVIEW for you to be able to run the example again. One thing I forgot to mention is that if you want to run the streaming examples, you will have to copy the wrapper DLL into the resource folder also. The wrappers can be found in the SDK also, so if we go back to the SDK and into the wrapper folder, and the drivers will be found in the release folder. This is the 32-bit version and this is the 64-bit. Now, as I am using 32-bit, I'm going to copy that into the LabVIEW resource folder. So programs x86, national instruments, LabVIEW, resource. Now that it's been copied in, I should be able to then open up the LabVIEW streaming examples. Let's just open that up quickly. As you can see, still another error, but it's found the DLL in the correct place. Now, this is the end of my video. I hope this will help you get started with LabVIEW.